It happened in a place called Wimpy's Tavern. I didn't know a soul in that dreadful place. Then I heard him call across the room from a dark and crowded corner. I knew his voice before I saw his face. Well, I wouldn't have thought of him for a greenback dollar. Of all the people in the world to meet, he shook my hand and spoke to me. Then he asked about my Mary. He hadn't changed a bit, Motor Mouth Harry. Well, we had a drink and Harry started bragging about the girls he fought off with a stick. I let him dream and make his brags and tell his funny stories. This was Harry's way of getting kicks. I told him to put a quarter in the jukebox and play some music while I wash my hands. He danced a jig and hollered out, then he acted kinda squirrely. It was my old friend, Motor Mouth Harry. I guess I've been in a thousand Wimpy's Taverns and read the little jokes on the dirty walls. The one about the man in France and the little words of wit, and a thousand more I know I can't recall. I can't describe the chill that came up on me. My heart stood still and my face was a solid stone. Up on that wall, among those words, I read the name of Mary, and underneath the number of my phone. I may spend my life alone in this old prison. I may never see my lovely wife again, but he'll never get the chance to write the name of my sweet Mary. 6 feet in the ground, Motor Mouth Harry.